seeking a bride for Isaac. Bible students seem well agreed that Isaac represents Christ, as Abraham gave his son Isaac, in whom centered the promises to be sacrificed. So the Heavenly Father gave his son Jesus to be the sin offering for Adam and his race, and received him again from the dead, as Abraham figuratively received Isaac. Isaac's bride, Rebekah, typified the Church of Christ, which is to become his bride in the resurrection at his second coming. The correspondences are remarkable. If Isaac represented Jesus, then Abraham would represent the Heavenly Father, and Eliezer, the servant sent to get the bride, would typify the work of the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of truth. The custom in olden times respecting marriage differed from the custom of our day. God evidently arranged that Jewish custom should illustrate spiritual things. Thus, instead of Isaac seeking a bride, Abraham sought a bride for him, sending by Eliezer. Thus, the picture is complete, as Jesus declares, "No man can come unto me except the Father which hath sent me draw him, invite him." As Rebekah was found with the sheep watering them, so those called to be the bride of Christ are usually found not in the fellowship with wolves, but with the Lord's sheep. Moreover, Rebekah and the sheep were found at the well, symbolically representing the desire of the little flock class for the water of life, the well representing the Bible. Rebekah was found serving water to the flock, representing well those whom Jesus would select for his bride class. He is seeking not for those who would lord it over the sheep, but those who feed, refresh, and serve them. The blessing upon Rebekah was, "Be thou the mother of thousands of millions." To some Bible students, this implies that the Church of Christ will mother in regeneration the millions of Adam's race, as the glorified Redeemer will be their everlasting Father.